all of us a chance to try to get right. Giving all of us a chance to make a decision about what we want to do. Do we want to enter into eternity, into the kingdom of heaven? Or will we take a different route? So I must believe that in his own time and in his own way, we may not understand it, we may not see it, but we can know within ourselves that God is shifting the atmosphere.
Amen. Amen.
I'm not going to be for you very long, but I do have a few things to say. This message came to me a few weeks ago, and for whatever reason I didn't get to bring it then, and but God said now is the time. So I want to first give honor to God for allowing me the opportunity to stand before you this morning.
Amen, amen.
Give honor to his son Jesus and his blessed Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Want to lead God and direct my path. I want to give honor to my pastor.
Amen, amen.
That he moved over a little bit and that he had this opportunity. And I just want to pray God's blessing on each and every one of you. Praying and asking God that as my spirit decreased, that his spirit would increase.
Amen.
I'm asking you, all of you that know the word of prayer, to pray with me and for me that God would use me, his earthly vessel, to say what thus says the Lord.
Amen.
And that he may get all the glory. So I just ask at this time that you please stand with me as I read the scripture. I ask that you turn with me to the Gospel of Luke, the 6th chapter. And I'm going to start at the first verse and down to the 13th verse. Gospel of Luke, the 6th chapter, the 1st through the 13th verse. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
I'm reading to you from the New King James Version. Now it happened on the second Sabbath after the first. Then he went through the grain field. And his disciples plucked the heads of grain and ate them, rubbing them in their hands. And some of the Pharisees said to them, why are you doing what is not lawful to do on the Sabbath? But Jesus answering them said, have you not even read this? What David did when he was hungry, he and those who were with him, how he went into the house of God and took and ate the showbread, and also gave some to those with him, which is not lawful for any but the priest to eat. And he said to them, the Son of Man is also Lord of the Sabbath. Now it happened on another Sabbath also that he entered the synagogue and taught, and a man was there whose right hand was withered. So the scribes and the Pharisees watched him closely, whether he would heal on the Sabbath, that they might find an accusation against him. But he knew their thoughts and said to the man who had the withered hand, arise and stand here. And he arose and stood. Then Jesus said to them, I will ask you one thing. Is it lawful on the Sabbath to do good or to do evil, to save life or to destroy? And when he had looked around at them all, he said to the man, stretch out your hand. And he did so, and his hand was restored as whole as the other. But they were filled with rage and discussed with one another what they might do to Jesus. Now it came to pass in those days that he went out to the mountain to pray and continue all night in prayer to God. And when it was day, he called his disciples to himself, and from them he chose 12, whom he also named apostles. I have read to you Luke, the 6th chapter, the 1st through the 13th verse. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, hearing, and doing of his most holy word.
Amen.
Amen.
I want to draw your attention back to that same chapter, but using as a text, I want to use verses 12 and 13. Now it came to pass in those days that he went out to the mountain to pray and continue all night in prayer to God. And when it was day, he called his disciples to himself, and from them he chose 12, whom he also named apostles.
All right.
I want to use as a topic this morning, God and our choices.
All right.
That's good.
God and our choices.
All right.
As I thought about this message, and then I knew it was the right message when one of the parents said this morning to Evangelist Tate and myself, one of our young men is going to be graduating from NKU, as Sister Fraser's grandson. And we all had thought that he was going to be going to, is it Miami? But however, he's going to Fresno, California. They had to make a choice.
All right.
Miami, whatever they was offering, Fresno offered a little bit more. So anytime we know how expensive it is to send children off to college, but anytime your child might get a free ride and a little something extra,
all right,
then that's the school you want to send them to. Especially if they're a good school.
Amen.
So I thank God for the revelation. So with graduation, many will have to make decisions in their lives.
That's right.
We make decisions every day. But many are now making life-changing decisions about the future. If we never learn how to make the right decision, then we will go through life unhappy, uncertain, and wondering what went wrong.
All right.
Choices are like legs. They give us movement and help us to get on with life on our own terms. They are also like doors. Through them we enter into new areas, although we are then shut off from where we previously came. Choosing has to do with making a selection between alternative, deciding about a matter, giving preference to one alternative over another, on the basis of some plan or criteria or end that is envisioned.
All right.
I work at a place, and they consistently at Children's Hospital say, change the outcome. Mm-hmm. And that's what choices and decisions is, especially to our young people. You have to change the outcome of whatever situation arises in front of you. You're going to have those friends that tell you, I thought you was my friend. If they trying to stir you wrong, whether you're their friend or not, they are not your friend. Because a friend is not going to stir you in the wrong way.
Amen.
And in the wrong direction.
Amen.
A friend will stick closer to you than anything else. You're like a brother or a sister to them. And instead of, if you don't want to do drugs, if you don't want to be in a gang-banging situation, if you don't want to drink, if you don't want to do a whole lot of things that your friend, so-called friend, will try to solicit you into doing, then you need to walk away.
That's right.
Amen.
With a friend like that, who needs any?
That's right.
So you have to envision the outcome And it's inevitable. You're going to always have to make some decision somewhere along the line. You can't get around it. It's not only for the young people, but it's for us, each and every one of us in here. Our text this morning tells us a decision time in the life of Jesus. That time when he had to choose and appoint leaders to extend his ministry to the masses of people. It is an account of how Jesus handled crucial decision making.
All right.
This account also grants insight into how God can relate to us when we need help to make wise choices. Jesus was concerned about the future of his work. He saw and felt the need to train a small group to expand his strategic ministry of preaching, teaching, and healing. There were needs among the people, many, many unmet needs, hurting hearts, brokenness, dreams, and hopes shattered.